السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعين به ونستغفره ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه ونعوذ بالله تعالى من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا إنه من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله بلغ الرسالة وأدى الأمانة ونصح للأمة فكشف الله به الغمة وجاهد في سبيل ربه حق جهاده حتى أتاه اليقين وتركنا على المحجة البيضاء ليلها كنهارها لا يزيغ عنها إلا هالك يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما أما بعد فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله تعالى وأحسن الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار وما قل وكفى خير مما كثر وألهى وإنما توعدون لآت وما أنتم بمعجزين إخوة الإيمان والإسلام أوصيكم ونفسي بتقوى الله عز وجل. All praises due to Allah. May Allah's peace and blessings be upon His beloved Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. I bear witness that there is no deity worthy of worship but Allah, alone without any partners. And I bear witness that Muhammadur Rasulullah is the true slave servant, prophet, and last messenger of Allah. May Allah's peace and blessings be upon him, his household, his companions, and everyone following his way and his path till the day of judgment. And we pray to Allah Azza wa Jal to make us among those who follow his path until we meet him subhanahu wa ta'ala. My dear brothers and sisters, whenever we reflect on the Qur'an, recite it, understand it, trying our best to understand it, and save no effort to implement it, and then try our best to qualify to teach it, we get the greatest of the khayr of this dunya and akhirah. You get the greatest of the goodness, the highest level of goodness in this dunya by doing so, and in akhirah as well. How? You follow the footsteps of Rasul al-A'zam sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Because he is the one who received this Qur'an. It came to him fresh, straight from heaven through Jibreel alayhi salam. So when you are attached to the Qur'an, you are closer to the one who received it, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Whenever you recite the Quran, whenever you listen to the Quran, whenever you enjoy the Quran, whenever you try to understand the Quran, try to live the Quran, you are closer to the one who received the Quran. So this is a rule of thumb, keep in your head for today, inshallah. So the more you are attached to the Quran, the more you are serving it, the more you are connected to it, practically speaking, the closer you are to Al-Habib al-Rasul Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So that's a source of joy in this dunya. Don't you think so? When you're feeling that, you know, I am reciting exactly the same way Jibreel alayhi salam was reciting to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The same way Abdullah ibn Mas'ud was reciting. The same way Rasulullah himself was reciting in salah. So when you stand there and you recite the Quran properly like that, you feel this. So in the dunya, it gives you that great, wonderful feeling that you are a true follower of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Also, it puts you in the leadership position. What do I mean by that? Allah Azza wa Jal, He says, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا أَطِيعُوا اللَّهَ وَأَطِيعُوا الرَّسُولَ وَأُولِي الْأَمْرِ مِنْكُمْ. Obey Allah, obey His Messenger, and obey those of leadership and authority among you. Abdullah ibn Abbas radiallahu anhuma, the greatest companion of Rasulullah and his cousin, the cousin of Rasulullah, the one whom Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Ya Allah, give him the knowledge of the true meaning of Quran. So when Abdullah ibn Mas'ud say this verse means, Abdullah ibn Abbas says this verse means such and such, you know who he is. So Abdullah ibn Abbas said, Ulil Amr are the people of leadership in the affairs of the dunya and also the people of the leadership in the affairs of akhirah. The ones who understand the deen of Allah and tell you how to be a good Muslim, to be closer to Allah. Those are our leaders as well. And he says, هُمُ الْأُمَرَاءُ وَالْعُلَمَاءُ وَهُمُ الْعُلَمَاءُ إِذَا عَدِمَ الْأُمَرَاءُ وَهُمُ الْعُلَمَاءُ إِذَا فَسَقَ الْأُمَرَاءُ. Abdullah ibn Abbas says, they are both the emirs and the scholars. And they are only the scholars if there is no emirs. And they are only the scholars if the emirs are corrupted. Those are waliul amr. Those are your ulil amr. Those are your leaders. So you become like that. The more you are attached to the Quran, I'm not saying that to claim something, that all of us here, collectively, we are all of us can have that status. By how much more you are willing to put in serving the deen of Allah and the Quran. Any one of us becomes our leader by just that. It is not a birthright. It is not a family right. It is not a financial right that you become a religious leader. All of us qualify to be that when you say La ilaha illallah, Muhammadur Rasulullah. But how much are you willing to sacrifice from your life, from your time, from your money, from your intellect to serve the deen of Allah and try to understand His book to guide others? So it is something earned. It is not something snatched or something like imposed on people. It's something earned. And then earn it from people. You earn it from people. People, when they see that someone is more knowledgeable, of course, you know, when you come to the masjid for salah, and the regular imam is not there, what do we as Muslims do? We look at each other, trying to see who is more qualified. Fitra. This is natural. It's not an extra effort of anything. Everybody looks, who's going to be the one? And subhanAllah, this is how Allah Azza wa Jalla guides us. Same thing in our deen, same thing. We look around and I ask the question, who is the most knowledgeable? Cool. So it's not like something to claim, something earned and given. So that's number two. When you are closer to the book of Allah, by reciting it properly, trying to understand it, implement it and teach it to others, you get that izzah. من كان يريد العزة فلله العزة جميعا. Whoever want the عزة, get it from who? From Allah. And Allah says, those ulama, Allah raised them above. Allah is the one who says, يرفع الله الذين آمنوا منكم والذين أوتوا العلم درجات. So you want the عزة, you want the leadership, get it from Allah. Get it from Allah. Allah said, قُلْ هَلْ يَسْتَوِي الَّذِينَ يَعْلَمُونَ وَالَّذِينَ لَا يَعْلَمُونَ Are they equal, those who have knowledge? فَاسْأَلُوا أَهْلَ الذِّكْرِ إِن كُنْتُمْ لَا تَعْلَمُونَ Ask the people of knowledge if you don't know. أَفَمَنْ يَعْلَمُ أَنَّمَا أُنزِلَ إِلَيْكَ مِنْ رَبِّكَ الْحَقُّ كَمَنْ هُوَ أَعْمَى Is the one who is blinded by the lusts and desires of this dunya like the one who sees the truth of Allah Azza wa Jalla through the knowledge? إِنَّمَا يَخْشَى اللَّهَ مِنْ عِبَادِهِ الْعُلَمَاءِ Truly the ones who fear Allah the way he should be feared are the ones who have knowledge and all of us qualify for that. So it is not a birthright. There is no like religious leadership appointed like because they are whatever it is. No. You go to Allah. Allah says you have to have 1, 2, 3. Rasulullah showed us and this is how the ummah agreed on. That's how you become. Alhamdulillah. That's why I tell everybody come and said, can you teach me how to memorize the Quran? Do you think I'm able to memorize the Quran? Yes, you are able to memorize the Quran before I even talk to you. You are able to memorize the Quran. But there are few factors. The factor is that do you have the time? Do you have the will? Are you ready for the sacrifice, for the challenge? For avoiding the distractions. And above all of this, are you willing to sit like a slave and cry to Allah for this gift to be given to you? It might not be given to you at the end of the day after we do all of this. But are all of us qualified to it? Yes. Basic, general. But what Allah decided will happen at the end. But you will never lose. This is one thing I'll tell you today. If you today, my brothers and sisters, decide to memorize the entire Quran, you are not losing anything. I swear by Allah the Almighty, from this place, you will gain. You will gain. From now until the time you die, you will gain. For sure, you will gain something. Even if you did not memorize a single ayah, which is impossible, nearly impossible, you know? Because once you did that, at least you memorized one ayah. But let's say even if you did not, that intention itself, that feat, that quest itself that you set yourself to do, by itself puts you higher than everybody else. And that's what I wanted to emphasize when you are closer to the book of Allah Azza wa Jal. You get the leadership from Allah. You gain people's respect. You become a safety net to your community. You become one of those stabilizing factors and helping factors in the community. You become a stabilizer in the community. Stabilizer in the community. When you read the book of Allah, at least we can point to that community, said the book of Allah is read among these people. See what you're doing now? You are saving your whole community, subhanAllah. See the Quran, what Quran does to you? It puts you to that level. In the dunya, we still did not talk about akhirah. In the dunya itself, being close to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, having the leadership by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, plus you become safety to those who are around you. Your house is the house that the Quran is recited in. All the houses around you don't recite the Quran. Safety comes to all this neighborhood because of you. Allahu Akbar. Because you are reciting Fatiha there in Tahajjud. Because you are reciting Qul Hu Allahu Ahad. Like this masjid is a safety for all this downtown Houston. Wallah, it is. The name of Allah is mentioned, Allahu Akbar. Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah. Ashhadu anna mu- Don't take this lightly. You coming and leaving your work and coming sitting here, that's a statement. You are saving everybody, saving. The rahmah of Allah comes around. You think Allah will waste those who are serving Him subhanahu wa ta'ala? Those who walked here because of a function or whatever happening, they walked all of this. You're getting more reward because you suffer today more. You see the blessing? You're coming to hear the ayat of Allah. The hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, you are not like anybody. So the izzah in the dunya, the leadership in the dunya, closer to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, also stabilizing the community and keeping the deen going among the people. Those are few, only few, scratching the surface of the good things that you get in the dunya. Taman, of course, all of this is great. But having that enjoyment and connection with Allah Himself is another deal. Because you are reciting the word of Allah Himself. That's a higher spiritual thing. We took the easy ones. But the big one is that Allah is talking to me and I'm talking to Allah right now. When you're reading Surah Al-Fatiha, who said Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen? Who said that word? Allah said that word. So you are repeating what Allah says. It's like Allah talking to you. Rahman Rahim, Malik Yawmuddin. Then you talk to Allah. Iyyaka na'budu wa iyyaka nasta'in. Ihdina as-sirata al-mustaqim. Then Allah said, you get it. Rasulullah said that, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Said Allah divided Surah Al-Fatiha to two. Allah said, I divided Al-Fatiha between me and my servant. When he says, Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen, I say, my servant praised me. When I say, Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim, my servant mentioned me. When I said, Malik Yawm al-Din, said, my servant glorified me. Iyaka na'budu wa iyaka nasta'een, only you worship and only you seek for help. Allah Azza wa Jal says to his angels, this is between me and my servant. This is some secret between me and my servant. إِيَّاكَ نَعُودُ وَإِيَّاكَ نَسْتَعِينَ. He knows now who is his Lord. Then, اِهْدِنَا الصِّرَاطَ الْمُسْتَقِيمَ صِرَاطَ الَّذِينَ أَنْعَمْتَ عَلَيْهِمْ. That is what we need to ask. Allah said, هَذَا لِعَبْدِي وَلِعَبْدِي مَسَأَلْ. This is between me and my servant and I will grant it for him. Conversation. Inshallah, let's feel this next time when you recite Surah Al-Fatiha, that you are in conversation with Malik al-Muluk. You are in the conversation with Ar-Rahman al-Rahim. Huh? If you say that I'm in conversation with the president of such and such, you dress, you know, suit and tie, and you're counting the minutes and the second, and the car is clean or not, and my socks smells or not, and my shoes shiny or not, and everything, mashallah, perfect. And when you go there, yes, sir, yes, this, that. And when you stand there, you're going to talk about it for the rest of your life, that I was there, and you want to make sure that you had a selfie to to show people what you did. But with Allah Azza wa Jal, He says, forget about all of this. You don't need any of this. Just do wudu and stand in front of me and say, Allahu Akbar, and I'm there. You get shortest way. The distance between you and Allah is putting your head down. Is to say, Allahu Akbar, and start. I want you to feel it, ya akhwani. That's when you are Quran, you get to that level. In Akhirah, Quran comes with shafa'a. Your recitation, the act of recitation, which is a concept. It's an non-tangible concept, not something that you can touch or feel. Your recitation of the Quran. But Yawm al-Qiyamah, it comes at something that you can touch and feel. It's a body. It's like a concept is a body now in Yawm al-Qiyamah. So Qira'ah of the Quran, each and every one of us, recitation of the Quran, it can be like an ant, or can be like a giant, can be like a mountain. كل واحد على حسب. Everyone according to their ability, you know? Everyone. That's why Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said the recitation of Baqarah and Ala Imran, those who recite them regularly, and inshallah you will be reciting them regularly after today, inshallah, Rabbul Alameen. Baqarah and Ala Imran, finish them, repeat again, finish them, repeat again, finish them, repeat again, until you say it from memory, inshallah. Yeah. He said that recitation will come Yawm al-Qiyamah in front of the one who used to recite them regularly to intercede in front of Allah. So if you are in trouble, said, Ya Allah, he used to recite, please save. And this is the words of Allah. After that, you cannot be thrown in fire, yeah. After this, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, the recitation of the Quran comes, تَقْدُمُهُمَا الْبَقَرَةُ وَآلَ عِمْرَانِ. Yeah, and the recitation of every surah, it's like a little child in front of you. And in front of those, the recitation of Baqarah and Al-Imran, recitation of Al-Fatiha, recitation of Al-Ankabut, Al-Rum, like this. You have an army of people in front of you. Every surah has its own shape, Yawm Al-Qiyamah, how you recite it. Like you recite Surah Al-Mulk every night, it will come like that in front of you. Like you are surrounded, the more you recite. Imagine if you are a hafiz now, huh? Now you understand what does it mean. Somebody says, oh, hafiz, is it fard? Is it? We're not talking about that now. Let's not talk about it. It's fard or obligation. It's not obligation. Okay. Hifz of the Quran is not obligation on you. What now? Listen to what I'm saying now. You want to be in Firdaus al-A'la? You're going to memorize Quran. Fine. It's up to you now. It's not an obligation to be in paradise. Highest. It's not an obligation. Is it obligation on you to go to Jannah? I know nobody asked you that question before. Is it an obligation on you to go to Jannah? No, it is not. It's a choice. The obligation on you to do the things that will take you to Jannah. Obligation is to pray. Obligation is to fast. Obligation is not to lie. Obligation is not to this. But nobody is obligated to go to Jannah. It's a fard on you to go to Jannah. Who say that? Allah said, fard on you to follow this. You say, I'm a Muslim, that's fard on you. But it's a choice. If you do your fard and sunnah and, you go to Jannah. That's why many people praying, but still they don't go to Jannah. And people will go to Jannah not because they're praying or Hajj or anything, because a little other act, you know. So we're invited to go to Jannah. All right. So in Yawm al-Qiyamah, Rasulullah ﷺ said, Baqarah and Al-Imran also come like a cloud, shading the people from the heat of that day. Or like two flocks of birds, like hundreds and hundreds of birds flocking over you, giving you comfort and all of that. Plus, Ahlul Qur'an hum Ahlul Allah wa khassatuhu. The people of the Qur'an, reciting it, memorizing it, teaching it, implementing it, living it, are the family of Allah. Allah does not have this physical concept of family, yani, that we have. Ta'ala Allah, قُلْ هُوَ اللَّهُ أَحَدٌ الله الصمد لم يلد ولم يولد ولم يكن له كفوا لم يكن له صاحبة ولا ولد. No wife, no children, did not beget, not begotten. We understand all of that. So when Allah says, those are my family, we understand now what does it mean. It means the close ones of Allah Azza wa Jalla, like a family for us, they are for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, close to Him. And who likes to hurt his family? Who does not want to take care of his family, give privileges to his family? If we are humans like that, you think Allah will not do it? Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Inna lillahi ahlina min al-nas. For Allah, there are people like family to Allah Azza wa Jalla. He said, who are they, ya Rasulullah? Anas ibn Malik narrated, Qala ahlul Qur'ani hum ahlullahi wa khassatuhu. May Allah make us all sitting here today from ahlul Qur'an. Say ameen. Ahlul Qur'an. Somehow. Today, inshallah, by the end of today, inshallah, khutbah, you decide I'm going to be from Ahlul Qur'an somehow. You're going to start it, Ikhwani, today. Don't let this khutbah go to waste. Act upon it, please. If you memorize three surahs, make them five. If you memorize five, make them ten. If you memorize a juz, make them three. Put a goal for yourself. Write it on the calendar. Write it on your device or whatever. But just do it. We want, if Allah give us life and sitting here next year, you say, Subhanallah, I benefited and I am praying to Allah to be from Ahlul Qur'an because today I am better than last year. I am ahead. 1 page, 2 page, 10 page, whatever it is. But do something. And do something regular. Attend the Qur'anic halaqa. Share it. Whatever you hear about Qur'an with your spouse and your children. Try to bring it to your life. Then Allah give you the degree in Yawm al-Qiyamah. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, يُؤْتَى بِقَارِئِ الْقُرْآنِ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ. Qari' in here is the hafiz who, the hafiz of the Qur'an who acts upon what he memorized. Not just the hafiz, you know. Not someone who repeats the words. No, someone, qari', that's why he said qari' al-Qur'an. He did not say hafiz al-Qur'an. Not the one who memorized, he said qari'. Qari' in Arabic, qari', Islamically and Arab, and how it's referred, Arabic language, how it's referred to in the time of Rasulullah means the knowledgeable people of Qur'an. Sahabatu yuqalu lahumul qurra'. Qurra' is the plural of qari'. Qari' is the one that not only reciting the Qur'an, knowing every word, knowing where it was revealed, what does that ayah means, he implemented, people can see it while reading it. You read the ayah and you see the person, that ayah. This is how this ayah is practiced. Like Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, like a Quran walking on earth. Sahaba were like that. You see, Abdullah ibn Mas'ud is different from everybody else. Ubay ibn Ka'b, different from everybody else. Abu Bakr as-Siddiq, different from everybody else. All the four Khalifa, they were hafiz of the Quran. Ubay ibn Ka'b, Zayd ibn Thabit, Abdullah ibn Mas'ud, all these Sahaba, they were different from other Sahaba. Different. That's why Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, you want Quran? Go to this. You want Quran? Go to this. They're living it. Some of the Sahaba, the younger, junior Sahaba and Tabi'een, they used to say, we go to the halqa of Abdullah ibn Mas'ud just to see him. They are not writing any knowledge or anything like that. They are just sitting there and looking. Oh, he stood up. Oh, he drank. Oh, he put his clothes like this. His hat. He moved. He did. That's what they wanted to see. How somebody who is the Quran himself acts like. And they learn that. They learn that. Some students are for the academics and some students for the etiquettes. All the Sahaba, Tabi'in, scholars are like that. Until our time now, there are some people just go learn etiquettes from. I know everything that they say, but I'm sitting in the halqa for something else. Everybody's busy writing and all that, but I'm watching this sheikh, what does he do? Allahu Akbar. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, that Qari of Quran will be brought yawm al-qiyamah. He's decided to go to Jannah already. He's decided to intercede for many of his family members who are doomed to go to hell. We'll bring them to go to Jannah with him as well, or her. But guess what? Allah says, اقرأ ورقة ورتل كما كنت ترتل في الدنيا. Allah Azza wa Jalla said, now go ahead, enjoy, recite and ascend like you used to recite in the dunya. فَإِنَّ مَنْزِلَتَكَ عِنْدَ آخِرِ آيَةٍ تَقْرَأُهَا. Your degree in Jannah is with the last ayah you memorize. So the more you memorize, you keep what? Like you are standing on an elevator, and that elevator has no buttons. It is voice activated. I call it the Quran activated elevator. Quran activated elevator. You want the elevator to keep going, taking you up, keep reciting. That's what Allah Azza wa Jalla says. So, أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. It works. الحمد لله رب العالمين. It keeps going up now. Keep reciting. Baqarah up. Al-Imran up. All up, up, up. Until Surah An-Nas comes. Where are you going to be now? Firdaus al-A'la. Highest degree in Jannah allowed for a human being below Rasulullah Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Up there. You memorize Juz Amma only. Here you go. You memorize this. Here you go. If you are from Ahlul Quran, many people will go to Al-Firdaus by other deeds. Oh, there are different routes. Now we are telling you a guaranteed route. The more of it, the more you go up. So here you go. One guaranteed route. You want to go the route of Ahlul Salah? Yalla, Bismillah. The route of Ahlul Hajj? Go to Hajj every year. You are out of this? Go. But that's a guaranteed route. May Allah make us among Ahlul Quran. Ahlul Allah wa khasatuh. Aqulu qawli hadha wa astaghfirullah li wa lakum. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه ومن والاه وبعد. The hadith of the Quran, talking about the Quran, حديث لا يمل مثل القرآن لا يمل وخير جليس لا يمل حديثه وترداده يزداد فيه تجملا. One of the scholars said, Quran, you never get bored of reciting it. So also talking about Quran, you never get bored of it. We can talk about Quran all our life actually is to figure it out. Don't you think so? All this deen is to figure Quran out. All this ahadith and the sunnah is to explain the Quran for you. So recite it. Recite it and enjoy it. That's my message to all of us today, my brothers and sisters. Quran, what will give you izzah in the dunya? Dignity in the dunya and dignity in akhirah. Quran is rewarding in the dunya. Reward of comfort in the heart. Clarity of the mind. Contentment of the soul. Quran is what will protect your eyes by looking at it, your ears by listening to it, your heart by thinking, and your mind by using that intellect and understanding it. Give barakah to your family, to your neighborhood. You become a safety net to everybody around you. Rahmah of Allah comes because of you. You are closer to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam the more you are engaged with the Quran. In Yawm al-Qiyamah, you will be called by your name. Your parents will be given the crown of izzah and karama, dignity and honor. And Allah will give them clothing of noor in front of everybody because they are the parents of the Qari of the Quran. So my brothers and sisters, today I came with this, the book of Allah. And I want to leave with the book of Allah, but I want to leave this message in your heart. Each and every one, inshaAllah, Rabbul Alameen, today we promise Allah that I am going to be better in Quran than before. That is the takeaway today from the khutbah. Today, I will be, inshaAllah, Rabbil Alameen, better in Quran than before. Extra time for reciting, extra time for reflection, extra time for halqa, extra time for hifz. And ask Allah Azza wa Jal, His rahmah, to come upon you and give you the gift of understanding and living the Quran. Allahumma ja'alna min ahli al-Quran ahlika wa khassatik. Allahumma ja'alna min ahli al-Quran ahlika wa khassatik. اللهم اجعلنا من أهل القرآن أهلك وخاصتك اللهم علمنا منه ما جهلنا وذكرنا منه ما نسينا وارزقنا تلاوته آناء الليل وأطراف النهار عباد الله إن الله أمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى ونهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون